सो वीआईटी वेल्लोर
To charge a battery of 12 volt, we need 14 to 15 volt. If the VM of the cell is 17.5 volt, we have to operate it less than the VM. In that case, efficiency of the cell will be reduced. How to compensate for it?
No, your VM as per the design is 16, 17, 18 volt, but your cell is not going to operate at a room at 25 degree centigrade. I told you that. Your cell, because it is encapsulated, will always have 15-20 degree centigrade higher temperature than ambient. So actually you will not get, in realistic condition, you will not get your VM of 17 volt. It will be dropped by 2-2.5 volt. The actual voltage that you will get is only about 14-15 volt. So why we designed for higher VM is just to take care of the temperature effect. Jaicham Rajendra College, Karnataka.
Sir, I want to know where did you consider the efficiency of the solar PV module?
In the design, you have not considered the efficiency of the PV module, but when you give your rating of a PV module, you know, rating of a PV module already takes care of that, right? How do we rate PV module? We rate PV module for 1000 watt per meter square. Okay, so when you say watt peak condition, when you say that rated power, it already considers the efficiency. Okay, it already considers the efficiency. So as a user, you don't have to bother about what is the efficiency of the module. You have to just see how much is the peak wattage it can provide you, and not the efficiency. You don't have to worry about the efficiency of the PV module. It already comes incorporated in the watt peak rating.
Sir, what would be the cost, approximate cost of the system you designed right now?
What would be the approximate cost of the system that I designed right now? It's a good homework to all of you. Okay, let me see how much it cost in Karnataka and how much it cost in Baramati. So this is the assignment to all of you: find out the cost of individual component, do the analysis, send it, and if you are happy with the design, if you believe me and my design is okay, you can actually install it. And if you are going to install, you'll get the real cost.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. A lot of questions. SGS ITS Indoor.
Sir, which parameter decides the depth of discharge of a battery?
It is decided by the material of the battery. It is decided by the electrode design of the battery. Okay, so for example, lead acid battery, which are used in the car, called SLI batteries, do not have deep discharge because the electrode is flat. But the deep discharge battery, which are used in a PV system, is called the tubular battery, right? Because their electrodes are circular, and they are kind of kept in the form of the tube, so that your electrode material is not kind of lost during the charging discharging. So it is the electrode, it is the design of the electrode, it is the material of the battery itself will decide all the parameters. Okay, NIT Surat. By the way, I have run out of my time. Professor Fernandez is already here. If you have any question for him also, please go ahead and ask. Professor Fernandez is also here. Okay, NIT Surat.
That if the system we have designed, in which if solar PV gives the output for only one day, so will it make the battery charge to use for the 3 days?
No, if we design the system for one day and you consider the autonomy of 2 days, so that we require a total charge of 3 days. Assume that yes, battery will get charged, because you cannot do the over design, right? The extra battery capacity that you consider, that is only for some emergency days, right? So if I understand correctly, that your battery capacity you have taken for 3 days, but the module we have taken only for 1 day. Now for that much extra capacity of the battery, we cannot actually have the module also extra, because that much battery capacity will be only used for couple of days in a year. And many times, you know, we have done the little bit over design, remember, we have taken more power than the required power, so that will take care of that battery charging. Warangal.
Sir, good morning, sir.
Sir, in the design that you have shown, battery calculations,
you have said that it will be 4 batteries, sir, but actually 300, when you put it in parallel, I think you need to have 6 batteries, sir. I think if you
okay,
see the
whiteboard, let me have a look at that.
Gone for the battery calculation.
Okay, so we have come up with the four batteries, right? So our energy requirement, ampere hour requirement was 373. We have chosen 100 ampere hour battery from the market. So 373 divided by 100, we require 3.73 battery, or we require 4 batteries. Now this 4 batteries charge capacity.
These 4 parallel sections, right? These 4 parallel sections are not 4 batteries.
No, so what was our charge requirement? 62.2 ampere at 24 volt and okay. Yeah, you are right. So we require
4 parallel sections, 8 batteries we need to require.
Right. So we have done the design for the 12 volt 24 volt charge. So there should be 2 such strings. So in each string there has to be 4 batteries. Is that you are saying? I'm sorry, there should be 4 parallel strings. Yeah. You are right. There should be. I'll check it, but I think you are right because we have done the design for once. Yeah. So 2 batteries in series, and there are 4 such parallel paths. I'll check it again. You also check it. That. Yeah.
Sir, one more question, sir. For grid system also, should the analysis should be done in the same way, sir? For grid interface with the PV modules.
Yeah, for the grid connected system also. See, remember the energy flow. Energy is conserved, right? So whatever I do, the simple way to actually design is just to look at the energy flow, right? So even if you are designing for 500 kilowatt or 1 megawatt, your input energy, output energy, if you take the energy flow and efficiencies of the component which are coming in the path, you can definitely do the very good approximate design.
Sir, load effect, that inductive load or capacity load, such type of things doesn't come into the picture, sir.
Well, it will come, but I mean, it will come, but I guess Professor Fernandez can answer that better. But I am just taking the efficiencies of each and every component, right? So energy must be conserved. The simple principle is that the energy must be conserved. So if I take that into account, I can actually get the approximate load.
What is the question?
For the grid side, sir, what will be the input, means grid load, how do you take as a grid load? Voltage, power and inductive load or capacity load, such type of things should be considered, sir, while you are doing this analysis.
No, what sort of analysis? I do not know. See, I do not
okay,
know.
Sir,
you want,
me,
you want
me,
to, you want to feed the power to the grid?
Let me tell you the question. So, this question is, I have shown them the design of a PV system for a standalone. He is asking if I am going to, can I design the PV system which is grid connected? What I have used is simple principle of energy conservation at each point, and I have taken energy flow from one point, one component to other, considering the energy efficiencies of the each component. With simple considering the efficiency of each component, can we also design the system which is grid connected? Is that the question?
Yes sir, exactly.
If I understand correctly, this is what is the question, right? Solar panel, whatever, finally the inverter, there could be any number of stages, and this is the grid. That's what procedure is the same, in the sense this, the rating of the inverter is KVA or VA. Okay. Now if you are feeding the power to the grid, generally what the grid wants is you feed the power at unity power factor. Okay? Feed the power at the unity power factor. In addition, if the grid wants reactive power, then you have to suitably have a so if you are feeding the power to the grid at unity power factor, V and I should be out of phase, that's all. This is V, this is I. So in when you're feeding power to the grid, generally it is expected that you do it at unity power factor. Otherwise, if the grid wants reactive power, then it operates at leading power factor. Definitely, it won't be lagging power factor. So that's it. So most of the time,
thank you, sir. This
most
was my
of the time
question,
it is unity power factor. Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Jabalpur.
My question is related to the problem which we have just solved.
Yeah, go ahead.
For the daily load requirement of 1.2 kilowatt hour, our PV module requirement is almost 1.8 kilowatt hour.
Right.
Which is almost double the capacity of our requirement.
Okay.
That means for business amount of small load, we have to install a double capacity PV module, and also there will be intermediate cost of other equipments like controller, inverter, battery, etc.
Why?
Will you think that this type of PV module would be economical for the total load requirement?
Well, your PV module, only your, if you look at the PV module power rating, it came about 311 watt only, okay. So, if your energy requirement is 1.27 kilowatt hour, okay, so definitely your input supplied must be higher than 1.27 kilowatt hour. And therefore, considering the all the efficiency, that is inverter and battery efficiency, your supply is 1.8 kilowatt hour, okay. This is, it is a energy kilowatt hour, it is not the power rating of the module. Power rating of a module came only 311 watt peak, not 1800 kilowatt hour, not 1800 watt hour, okay. The power rating only came 311 watt peak. So definitely if your consumption is 1270 watt hour per day, your supply must be higher than that, because energy is getting lost in the battery and inverter operations. Okay, and the cost is your perspective, right?
But sir, another country, they are going to have efficient PV module.
Madam, how do you go to office? Do you go by cycle or by walk or by car? How do you go to office, by cycle or by walk or by car? No, most economical thing is to walk. Okay, or to go by cycle. So why do you come by car then? It is not economical. Okay, so it is your perception what is economical and what is not. If you want to use solar power, yes, it is.
What type of regular maintenance is required for solar PV module once it is being installed?
The regular maintenance is, as far as the PV module is concerned, it is just a cleaning of a PV module, that's it. And if you want to generate more energy, you can do the sun tracking as we discussed in the first and second lecture. As far as the battery goes, battery requires maintenance. Battery should not, you should ensure that battery is not going to deep discharge, that the water level in battery is sufficiently high all the time. That is the two main maintenance part. Okay, so now we are taking a general questions. You can go ahead and ask any question related to the whole course, okay, any part of the day, any 10 days. Professor Fernandez is also here, you can ask any question. NIT Trichy.
Made in this problem, sir.
Okay.
Sir, Solangi, sir, please.
Yes, yes, I am hearing.
Sir, the inverter design you made,
yes,
254 watts in your whiteboard slide, it is there.
Okay.
So, if you made it as 254 watts, when you make it as a VA, you wrote it as 250 VA.
Okay. Yes.
By the battery, inverter is 254, the VA, I think it must be greater than that.
It must be greater than, I have just taken approximation that, suppose, you know, 250 volt ampere inverter is available, but yeah, normally it should be greater than this. Also, I assume that all the loads are operating at the same time. Now, that may not occur, and that's why I have taken it to be lower side, but yes. In order to be the safe side, you can take higher side, right? This 254 came assuming that all the loads, all three CFLs, all two fans and a computer is operating at the same time. Now, that situation may not occur all the time, okay. And also, you know, if you operate your inverter at a part load, efficiency are normally lower. So, if you try to match the load with the full rated capacity, then it is inverter efficiencies are higher. But to be on the safe side, you can take higher, but one of the disadvantage could be a little lower efficiency, because in that case your inverter will not always operate at a full load condition.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Jaipur College, Kukas.
Sir, I want to ask, like, in the system which we are using DC load, the first system which is shown in which a panel is array connected to the DC load.
Okay.
Sir, in that case, the voltage, the power of the panel is changing according to the intensity, or it is varying. So, according to load power, how much panel should be decided?
Yeah, so one simple thing you should do is try to match the rating. One simple thing you should try to make the rating of the load with the PV panel. Okay. So if you are going to do that, at least the power rating should match, but not only the power rating, you should actually have your module should have sufficient voltage. So that will determine the choice of your module. Okay. So not only the power, but the sufficient voltage level also should be matched. So that will determine the choice of your module. So it may go for 40 watt module, 6 volt module, or it may require 40 watt but 12 volt module, depending on the load requirement. But what you should do is actually the maximum power you can get from the module and the load power requirement, at least that much you should match. And you see that in the morning evening condition the radiation is lower, so actually you should choose a module of higher voltage. Professor Fernandez will answer that.
No, don't get offended. Don't you think, can't you do of your own all this? You know the load requirement, how much of what should be the rating of the solar panel that is required given the battery. Why can't you do of your own? Why you want an answer for all this? In the sense, better that you do of your own. You may commit a mistake here and there, it's fine, you learn. Otherwise, if you take suggestions every time and go and do, you may not have the confidence to do by yourself. And these are basically very simple concepts. At maximum, he is saying power balance, that's all. Yeah, while choosing the power, you should choose appropriate voltage and current. Now, please don't get offended. I was here, I've been listening to the answer. What is the cost, sir? What is this? What is that? I think most of the questions, I think you need to find out by yourself. Thank you, please. This is for all the participants. Don't get offended. That's the way one learns. I'm sure even Solanki also has learned through his own experience.
Slampur.
Hello, sir. I have two questions. How can we make the solar PV modules durable when specifically used for solar water heaters? And my second question is, what is greenhouse gas effect and how it affects the efficiency of solar cells?
Greenhouse gas, madam, you might have studied in your 12th standard, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. Okay, so it is result in increase in cell temperature. And the so first question I couldn't understand clearly.
How can we make solar PV modules durable, or what precautions we can take when we use it as a solar water heaters?
Solar PV module, you are not recommended to use solar PV module as a solar water heater. Amrita?
For previous analysis we have did, for converting a DC to AC, we have facing lot of power losses. So why not we convert all the home appliances to a DC, so and instead of that AC? Because the household loads are consuming the large power. So why not we convert all the households to a DC equipments? And better we utilize our PV modules for higher power plant as a AC, for AC distribution.
Good idea. Yeah, we can do that. No problem. In fact, there are all, if you wish, you can find out the DC components of all types. You can find DC refrigerator, you can find DC light, you can find DC fan. Everything is available in DC. You just have to work little bit harder to get them. But nobody will stop you to do that.
It is found that 48 volt DC direct volt DC transmission for residential, it requires less resources than equivalent AC. I was supposed to show today. I do not know why I did not bring the transparencies. If you wish, I will upload those two papers in the Moodle. You go through it. Our study shows that 48 volt DC transmission for a household requires less resources compared to AC. Okay, because we believe that. Okay.
Okay, Shivaji Nagar, Kolhapur.
Sir, my question is to Farnani sir. I want the suggestion. We have to consider considerations to increase the efficiency of inverter.
Sir, in the sense, I do not. I am no god. But you tell me, if you want to increase the efficiency, what do I need to do? I have to reduce the losses. What are the losses in the inverter? The device turn on, turn off, and conduction losses. Okay. Now, conduction losses you may not be able to reduce, or you may not have a choice. Okay. But then turn on and turn off losses you may be able to eliminate by using what is known as the soft switching. I did mention to you that. Okay, but then if you use soft switching, you may be able to eliminate, or you may be able to reduce the turn on and turn off losses. Conduction losses will remain the same. Okay, but then the process of complexity, circuit complexity increases. That's all. So if you do soft switching, you can try to improve the efficiency, but then complexity, control complexity will increase. That is expected, that whatever that you do in life, you have to pay a price. So if you try to improve the efficiency, your control complexity will increase. These issues I have already discussed. I have nothing more to say on this.
Let's take one by many.
Yeah, there are plenty of questions.
Okay, Baramati, quick.
We have purchased 8 panels of 72 watts, total 600 watt for 72 households, and 6 batteries of 180 ampere hours, as well as 1.5 kilowatt inverter for our Department of Physics laboratory load. Now we want to upload our power into national grid. Sir, that is all. But my question is that, first question, when batteries connected in series, there is the ampere hour does not get added. It's not.
When batteries are connected in series, ampere hour does not get added. It's the same thing, right? If you put the PV cells in series, the current doesn't get added, right? Same current has to flow. So when you put the things in series, it's voltage that will get added, right?
We have discussed different solar technologies to improve the efficiency of the solar cell. How we can use concentrators to improve the efficiency of the solar cell? And is there any PV module provided with the heat sink? Because we have discussed under these technologies under the STC condition.
Standard PV modules do not come. Okay, I got your question. Standard PV modules do not come with the heat sink because the cell, they are designed to, you know, they are designed to operate at 40-50 degree centigrade easily. It's part of the design. The concentrator technology we have not discussed because of the lack of time. But if you look at the efficiency of the solar cell, you know, you have the open circuit voltage, you have the short circuit current, you have the fill factor, and divided by Pn, right? So if you are now going to concentrate light, if you concentrate by x times, okay, if you concentrate by x times, what will happen to your efficiency of the cell? Your VOC will increase. How it will increase? Log function. What about the current? It will become x times directly because a linear function, assuming your fill factor remain constant, which is normally not the case, and your input power is increasing by x times, right? So this x gets cancelled with this x. Assuming your fill factor is constant, because your open circuit voltage is increasing logarithmically, your efficiency will also increase logarithmically as a function of x concentration. So in this way, if you can manage your fill factor constant, which will also depend on temperature, If you can manage this as a constant, if you avoid your losses, then actually you can get higher efficiency than the normal efficiency without concentration. Okay, so this is without concentration and this is with concentration. So that is possible, but this is a big question whether you can manage your fill factor constant, and it requires a lot of investment in the new design of solar cell. It requires investment in the cooling of solar cell, because temperature losses will increase if your concentration increase. Okay, so that is the answer in very brief. We don't have time to go into more detail. Manipal?
Yes, sir. Actually, under the concept of this distributed energy system, each household can, the SPV can generate power. It can use in the, whatever the partial can be used, and the partial energy can be delivered to the grid. But under the condition of variable voltage and frequency of the grid, and also the varying input of the, because the solar energy also variable, how effectively we can tackle this technologically? Is it?
I have told this maybe umpteen number of times. See, one, somehow I don't agree with you saying that you have grid voltages, we have a variable voltage, variable frequency. Voltage might change at the distribution level, but then frequency does not change. Frequency varies for a very narrow range, okay? Doesn't matter, okay? But then you have a solar panel, inverter, grid, okay? You have an MPPT here. It will extract the maximum power and transfer it to the capacitor. And this inverter will transfer the power to the grid in such a way that it tries to maintain the DC link voltage constant. Okay? You might have a variable voltage and variable current source at the input. Okay? But then at this point, voltage is maintained constant. How do I do that? Whatever the power that is coming from the solar, I'm saying power. Whatever the power that is coming from the solar cell, if I transfer it to the grid, this energy storage element will not do anything. If there is a mismatch of power, either it will receive or it will supply. If it receives, this voltage will increase. If it supplies, this voltage will fall. If I try to keep this voltage constant, there is a power balance. That's all. So, this is the input voltage. I'm assuming that power is transferred at unity power factor, okay? So current is out of phase. Just by changing the magnitude of this current, I can change the power transferred. That is one way. That is one way. Just by changing the magnitude of this current, I can change the power transferred to the grid. Because V into I, cos theta seem to be 1, is equal to power. Okay? How do I choose the magnitude of this current? It is same thing, same closed loop that I had discussed. VDC reference, that's the suitable value that you need to regulate. Actual, error, PI regulator. Now this could be either the magnitude of this current waveform, or angle between the two voltage sources, V1, V2 divided by X into sine delta. All this time I've been saying V1, V2 divided by X into sine delta. So under that condition, output of the PI regulator is delta. So this is not the first time that I'm discussing. I might have told this at least 3 to 4 times. Simple circuit theory. Power balance is the concept that has to be used. Now, how to generate a same volt, the waveform whose frequency is same as that of grid? For that, you need to use PLL. That's all.
Okay, Calicut.
So, if we replace the back side of the PV panel, we can increase the cooling rate of the PV panel. Thereby, we can reduce the temperature effect. Then, why industries are not going for this concept?
No, it is. So how do you replace, if you are going to replace Tedlar with something which can take heat away, that material has to be metallic in nature, right? So if you are going to put an aluminum sheet on the backside with some kind of fin arrangement, it is going to increase the cost. Okay, so when it comes to industry, when it comes to economy, you have to optimize which component will aid the cost, which component will reduce the cost. So under the optimized condition, it is economical to use Tedlar and not any cooling arrangement. Even if you use any cooling arrangement, the cell temperature you may reduce by 2 or 3 degree centigrade, because your cell is still encapsulated. You have to still encapsulate with the polymer sheet on the top and bottom. So even if you are using a cooling arrangement, it will come after the cell and then your encapsulant and then your metal sheet. So even if you have good cooling arrangement, your cell temperature you may reduce only by a couple of degree centigrade. So your cell will still be working at a higher temperature, and therefore it will not, any solution which brings down the, try to look at the decrease in temperature by having some fin arrangement is not economically viable. Nagpur, last question, then I will answer two quick question on the chat. Nagpur.
My question is for the MPPT tracker. Sir, in the MPPT tracker, our V reference as well as the actual voltage goes on changing. So how will the PI regulator regulate it? Because both the reference as well as the actual voltage is changing. How can the PI handle this, sir?
Which contest are you talking about?
So MPPT tracker.
Yeah, so
MPPT tracker, sir, MPPT.
So what happens in MPPT tracker? I don't know.
Compare the reference voltage with the actual voltage of a DC to DC converter. Our reference as well as actual voltage goes on changing.
See,
how will our PI regulate?
Ma'am, what the MPPT does, MPPT tries to operate the solar cell at the maximum power point. At a given operating point, it calculates the power. If it is and it just gives a disturbance, goes to another point. In that power, if that power is higher than the previous one, it goes to a higher point. That is so called the hill climbing. Which voltage and currents are changing? See, it doesn't matter. Operating point at the input may be changing. Yes, depending upon the sun's insolation, max the operating point will change. Therefore, both V and I change. But then you are transferring power to the output stage where it is stored in a capacitor, okay? And that power from the capacitor, either it is dumped to the grid or it is being consumed. Now that voltage, output voltage, is being regulated by the inverter, not by the MPPT regulator.
DC converter, not about the inverter side.
Ma'am, try to understand. Don't confuse with the boost converter volt controller loop. No. What the boost controller does is, the MPPT generates a duty cycle for the switch such that it extracts maximum power from the solar cell and it is transferred to the output capacitor. That's all. That power has to be transferred to the grid by the inverter. Therefore, the inverter does the voltage control. Boost controller does not do the voltage control. It's the inverter which does the voltage control. If there's only a boost controller, then yes, output of the boost, the controller of the boost regulator will has to regulate the output voltage. Fortunately here, output power is being processed by the inverter, so the inverter has to do the voltage control. So you have to consider the entire system and then you have to decide which function, which inverter, which block will do which control function. So DC to DC converter will extract the maximum power, it is transferred to the capacitor, inverter from the capacitor, it transferred to the source.
Okay sir, thank you sir.
Thank you.
Okay, so let us stop here. Thank you to all of you.